Gauge is the measurement of the diameter of a wire, or how thick it is. The thicker the wire, the more current it can handle. Now, if we pass too much current through any copper conductor, the excess electrons can create a lot of heat, which of course can be a fire hazard. So for this reason, wires come in standardized gauges, so we know exactly how much current they can safely handle. Unfortunately, this isn't completely standardized all around the world, but here in the United States, our standardization is called AWG, or American Wire Gauge. Now, this AWG chart shows the current rating for most of the gauges we see in production. Now, one thing to note, you can see that the higher number is actually a smaller gauge, which is a bit counterintuitive. But you can see that for 20 amps of current, we need to use at least 12 gauge copper. Residential power, which is commonly distributed in 15 amp circuits, is usually either 12 or 14 gauge wiring. And for the wiring actually inside of our gear, connecting the electronic circuits, the gauges get much smaller. Now, since one physical power cable carries multiple wires, we often see the rating printed on the cable with two numbers. The first one refers to the gauge, and the second one refers to the number of conductors. So this cable we can see is 12 gauge with three wires, three conductors, which we can use for one 20 amp single phase circuit. Or the Socapex cable we looked at earlier is 1219, which is 19 conductors, each of which is 12 gauge, which gives us six 20 amp circuits. But when we need to conduct a lot of current, like with feeder cables, the gauge needs to be quite heavy. Number 2 feeder is quite common to see, but we sometimes need the even heavier gauge of 2-aught or 4-aught. For example, if we have a 100 amp 3-phase distro, we need to make sure that each feeder cable is rated for 100 amps. Looking at our chart, we can see that we would need number 2 feeder, which is capable of handling that kind of current. And to see how much power this is actually providing, we can use our equation, watts is voltage times amps. So we can see at 120 volts, 100 amps gives us around 12,000 watts, or 12 kilowatts. But remember, the total available wattage does change depending on some variables. If the voltage is lower than 120, say 110, then the total power of our system will also drop. And the actual voltage we get from the grid or a generator is rarely a totally consistent 120. Or if we have to use really long feeder, that cable has a higher built-in resistance, so we do experience some voltage drop from long power runs, in accordance with Ohm's law. In any case, you don't want to be cutting it too close, so always leave headroom when you are calculating your power needs.